So, if S is the start symbol, then dollar is in hollow S. Why? Reason is that if you have some grammar rule like this, S to whatever, say A capital A, and as this is a start symbol S, so what we do? We augment the grammar by adding a dollar sign at the end of the body part of start symbol S. So, hollow S, if you think about, okay, so if we have any production rule with which is looks like this, S to say A and capital B, okay, and S is the starting symbol of the grammar, then what do? We augment the grammar by adding a dollar sign at the end of the first starting production rule. So now if you think about follow S. Follow S is nothing but you can say follow of A B, right? Now who is following this A and AB together? Who is following dollar? Because dollar is coming after small a capital B, so you can write dollar in the follow set of the start symbol of a grammar. Okay. Next is A. A to alpha B beta is a production rule. Then everything in first beta is in follow B except epsilon. So we don't write epsilon usually in the follow set. Okay. So, you look at this production rule, it is saying that A to alpha B beta, okay? And we are searching for follow of D, okay? We are trying to calculate follow D. So what will be the follow B? It is definitely whatever symbol will come at the first of beta. So you can write, whatever comes at the first of beta will follow B. So first of beta we write like this. First of beta, right? But it is provided that except the epsilon symbol, okay? So that we need to take care that epsilon symbol, epsilon is not going to be put in the follow set, because in follow set by default we, as you know, okay, the follow set we are not going to include it. Okay, now if A to alpha B is a production rule, or A to alpha B beta is a production rule, and epsilon is in first beta, then everything in follow A is in follow B. So you understand this very carefully. If this is the situation, A alpha, sorry, if this is the first situation, if you see A to alpha B, okay. Now if we are trying to search what is the follow of B? That means who will come at this after B? Whatever you will get, you know, from B derivation, doesn't matter. Who will follow them? Understand? So who will follow? As you can see, if we drive with A, the B, the derivation of B, whatever will be, that will always be at the end position. Okay, so that, you know, whatever B is generating, that will be always at the end position. Now, if we know what is follow A, then we can say simply, whoever is going to follow A, that means, you know, after deriving the body of A, whoever will come here, that will also follow B, right? So you can write here, follow B equal to follow A. Another condition can arrive, that is A to alpha B beta. Now in this situation, if you think what will be the follow of B, if beta not equal to epsilon, then what will happen? If that means whatever we come at the beginning of beta, that will follow B. So that is what we have already done here, right? Equal to first beta. But think about this, provided this. But if beta can be, if beta can be reduced to epsilon, then what? If beta can be reduced to epsilon, then from this we can raise to a form A to alpha B, and this beta is epsilon, so nothing, right? So in that case, this, who will follow this B? In this case, see, if this beta becomes epsilon here, then it is same like this production rule, right? This production rule and this production rule become same, then the same formula will be applied, that follow of B will be simply follow of A. Okay, this production rule will be applied here, and it will be only applied when this beta is epsilon, okay, or it is going to be epsilon, okay. And I think in a, about a situation that this beta can be epsilon or may not be epsilon, then what will happen? Then we will make union of follow beta equal to follow A union first beta, okay, because first beta will get a chance to follow B when beta is not going to be epsilon, and if beta is going to be epsilon, then follow A set will get chance to follow B. Understand? Okay. Now here is a given grammar. We have to find out follow position of each of the grammar variables or non-terminals. So what we do, as I have already told you, that we assume that the, if this is our first production rule, that means E is start symbol. If A is our start symbol, then we will assume or we will augment the grammar by adding a dollar here. Okay? So, if we are trying to calculate follow of E. See, only one E is available here, no other rule is having E. Yes, here we have a E, right? So who can follow E from this first rule? As E is the starting symbol, we can say dollar can follow E, right? And at the last rule here, you can see who is following E. Answer in the chat box. Who is following E? So here you can see that in this last rule, closing bracket is following E. That means following E means who is coming behind E or after E, right? Done. Then next variable we have is E dash. Now check out who is following E dash. Here from here you can see E dash is followed by dollar. So dollar will come here. Okay. Then is there any other appearance of E dash? If you think about this plus T E dash, then it is always going to be generated by this, right? Like, you know, E 2 T E dash, then only you can have the, you can apply this rule, that is plus E dash to plus T E dash. And again, if you expand this, then again you are going to get the same thing until you are doing E dash epsilon. If you are not doing it is epsilon, then E dash is again going to give you E dash. So you can understand that this E dash is always appearing at the last position. So you can say the dollar will follow this E dash. This is one chance. Another chance can be there. That is, the last rule, if you see, the last rule, if 2 E, you can see F 2 E, sorry, F 2 opening bracket E, closing bracket. Now this E can give us plus T E dash, right? Now at this situation, this E dash can be followed by opening, closing brace. Done. Next is T. So you have to calculate follow of T. Okay, so you see here T is followed by E dash, and T is followed by E dash. So we can write that follow T equal to first of E dash, and this E dash is epsilonable. Sometimes this E dash can be epsilon. In that case, this T will be the last symbol. If say this E dash becomes epsilon, T will be followed by dollar, right? So we make union of follow of, we can say E, right? Or you can say follow of E. Yes, no issue. Okay, so first E dash we had calculated in our previous class. So let's go back and see. First E dash was here plus and epsilon. Okay, so plus and epsilon. Okay, hollow A we already have here, dollar and closing bracket. Okay, now I have told you that in the follow set you don't need to write this epsilon, so you may not write epsilon, so your answer will be plus dollar and closing bracket. Okay, next is follow of T dash. Now if you look at the condition of T dash, so where T dash is arriving, you see here, and it is, you know, generated by T. So it is something like this: T to F and T dash. So who will follow T dash? Follow T will follow T dash, right? So we can write follow T dash equal to follow of T. Any other place is there where T dash is appearing? Yes, one place it is appearing, that is at this place, right? At this place, this T dash will be generated by T dash itself. So follow up T dash will be follow up to this T dash, and this T dash will be same. So no need to take, you know, any headache for that. So we already know follow up T, which is given here. So this will be come here. Okay. So follow T dash we have calculated. Next, last variable is available, that is air. You can see here where F is appearing here, but as a last rule, so we have to look at here. Okay, here we have F followed by T dash, here we have F followed by T dash, so we can simply write follow F equal to first of T dash, right? But at the same time, this T dash can be epsilon. We have a rule T dash to epsilon. Now if this T dash becomes epsilon, at that time what will happen? Who will follow? Then that time this F will be followed by follow of T. So union of follow T. And at this position, if this happens, this T dash goes to be epsilon, then follow T dash. Okay, and you can write union follow of T dash. Okay, now first you have to search what was there first T dash. First T dash we had calculated in our previous class. If you see, yes, here asterisk and epsilon. So this first T dash gives us asterisk and epsilon. Follow T and follow T dash are same, which are plus dollar and closing bracket. Okay, and as I have told you, this epsilon is not need to be written here in the follow set. So remove epsilon. So our result becomes asterisk plus dollar sign, closing bracket. Okay, so we have calculated all the follow positions for the given grammar. Understand? So this was regarding how to calculate first and follow position. Now at this moment, if you have any question or anything to ask, you can clarify, because this is very tricky thing, very simple, but if you miss something, you are going to lose marks. So if you want to ask me anything, you can ask me.